It is only natural for thieves to hate or be suspicious of other thieves. Natural Wants Mom, circa 2008. Maybe. Hi, hello, and welcome again, everybody, to another episode of Natural Juan. This time around, we're going to discuss the fiends, or evil spirits, of the Pathfinder RPG. Before all that, though, I'd like to invite you all to subscribe to my channel and hit that bell for notifications. Also, shout out to Mr. Jonathan Green, my patron in Patreon. If you would also like to support my channel and what I do here, you can find my Patreon information in the description below, along with PayPal and GCash if you want to make a quick, one-time donation. As a warning note, fiends and evil spirits are not topics for everyone, so I strongly suggest discretion when watching this video. Also, if you are below the age of consent or are put off by this kind of topic, you can skip this video and wait for my next one. I actually have a lot of other videos on this channel if you want to see other examples of my work. So, without further ado, let us plunge into the depths of the negative energy plane and meet some new fiends. So what does the word fiend even mean? Well, in modern or common parlance, fiend is often used to refer to evil spirits in general or bad people. Also, words like demon or devil are often used to refer to the same thing, being unclean spirits or spirits not on the side of or authorized by God. Then we have foreign words like oni in Japanese folklore, which is sometimes associated with ogres, asura, which is actually closer to the Greek titans in Hindu mythology, and klipoth, which refers to strange beings in Jewish mysticism. However, in the setting of Pathfinder, which is in turn based on the settings put forth by Dungeons & Dragons 3rd edition, these words take on different meanings. One of the things to consider when referring to fiends is the truth that evil people cannot really remain united for very long. Either one of them will grow to become too ambitious to tolerate the other, or one of them will have some sort of epiphany and become disillusioned with their alliance. This is true of the many evil spirits of Pathfinder, as while they might all be evil, they are in reality too selfish to build any kind of lasting relationship together with others of their kind. Again, this ties in with the idea of character alignment, which comes from Dungeons & Dragons as well. I will elaborate on this concept in a future video, but for now I would like to focus on discussing fiends and their motivations. That said, as a quick guide, examples of the 9 character alignments in media include RoboCop for lawful good, Spider-Man as neutral good, Robin Hood as chaotic good, James Bond as lawful neutral, Godzilla as true neutral, Jack Sparrow as chaotic neutral, Thanos as lawful evil, Hannibal Lecter as neutral evil, and the Joker as chaotic evil. This is so as to avoid confusion when discussing the alignment of the beings in question. So first up, we'll start with devils, who are one of the 3 major races of fiends in the Pathfinder setting. As one would expect, devils are more like the fallen angels often discussed and feared among the Abrahamic faiths such as Judaism, Christianity, and Islam. Devils make their home in the plane simply called Hell, and are ruled by a great fiend known as Asmodeus. Many of their founders, including Asmodeus, were once angelic or heavenly figures, but through their selfishness, waged war with the forces of good, and were hence sent or fled to the negative energy plane, where they now make their home. It should be known that while devils are considered lawful evil, and thus have a concept of law and order, one should be careful not to mistake this as an act of good. While devils do indeed place importance upon laws, these laws are often twisted to mean only the letter and not the spirit. So for devils, it's not so much as thou shalt not steal, but thou shalt not get caught stealing. And their laws almost always favor the strong and powerful, while the weak are forced to become pitiful slaves. Next, we have demons, who make up another of the 3 major races of fiends in the setting. Demons are less like the lawful evil devils and are actually chaotic evil, meaning they are dedicated to selfish pleasures rather than opposing the forces of good. That said, that doesn't make them any less dangerous or destructive. In truth, demons are actually created from the extreme emotions of evil mortals who have died and still possess some of their memories, but most certainly not their personalities, especially those that can be considered good. Demons make their home in the abyss, which is another part of the negative energy plane, and there they contend with one another for power and dominance. Demons are ruled by two deities, with Lamashtu representing the insidious nature of selfishness, and Rovagug, who simply represents destructive impulses. Indeed, among demons, things are a lot simpler. The strong rule the weak, and it is either victimize others or become a victim yourself. Anything goes, as some people would say, and if you're in a position or have enough power to do so, then you are welcome to fulfill your greatest desires, even if it means taking advantage of or destroying innocent people. Then we have the daemons, who sit between both devils and demons, being neutral evil, and a third major race of fiends. That said, these beings are quite probably the more dangerous of the three, as they lean more towards being the pure evil faction, regardless whether what they do has any reason or not. Indeed, daemons are ruled by a sense of nihilism, seeking to destroy anything and everything simply because of their hatred. So to them, it doesn't matter whether you murder with a sense of purpose, or if you want to fool others for your own gain. As long as it causes destruction of morality, it is an acceptable effort. Note too that daemons care much more about the soul than they do anything physical. So destroying something sentimental is more favorable to them than destroying a generic object that is more expensive. They might take greater pleasure in destroying a family pendant than, say, a finely crafted sword made among 100. Daemons are ruled by the four horsemen, which I discussed in a previous video, and the undead goddess Urgathoa, who is thought to be the mother of plagues and corruption. Other fiends in the setting, which are less well known but are nonetheless noteworthy in their own right, are the Khitans, who dwell in the land of shadow. While they are nominally considered evil by those who encounter them, the truth is actually more complex than that, but no less horrific. In truth, Khitans, whose real name is actually Velstrax, are spirits who seek art and stimulation at any cost. So while they might not have any malicious intent towards others, that will not stop them from absconding with innocent victims, skinning them alive, and then calling them art. Another interesting set of fiends in the setting are the Klipoth, beings from the abyss who openly oppose demons and sin. Again, much like the Khitans I've mentioned, just because they're against sin doesn't make them good. In truth, they want to wipe out all sin in the world, along with all those who commit them, including, of course, the countless mortals for even thinking of committing sins. In the end, Klipoths are simply too alien and hostile to mortals to be considered anything benign, and, much like the Khitans, are considered evil for their hatreds of all things mortal. Then we have the Sakil, who were once psychopomps or deliverers of the souls of the dead, who have rebelled and started their own nightmare realm in the ethereal plane. There, these beings create all kinds of nightmares for mortals and cause them untold amounts of fear and anguish. Sakil seek nothing but to subjugate others through fear and nightmares. There are many other fiends in the setting of Pathfinder, like the Divs, who are essentially evil genies, the Demodans, who are the spawn of Titans, and the Dorvay, who, while similar with the rest of its kind, are actually individualistic in their evil. All things considered though, the main takeaway from this discussion of the evil spirits of Pathfinder is that evil, while seemingly cunning and somewhat powerful, is all too often destroyed by its own nature, and that there is very rarely a lesser evil. Indeed, evil is evil no matter what form it takes, and that the idea of a necessary evil is all too often the wishful justification of evil men to commit atrocities. Anyway, that's it for this episode of Natural Juan. If you enjoyed this video and want to see more like it, don't hesitate to subscribe to my channel and hit that bell for notifications. Also, if you'd like to support my channel and what I do here, you can check my Patreon information in the description below, along with a PayPal and GCash account for making one-time donations. Natural Juan,